Hi, everyone. In the past few weeks, we've been witnessing a surge in attack campaigns worldwide. We're seeing numerous organizations being impacted by these campaigns worldwide that are unique in the sophistication and scale of the attacks that they include, and more specifically, the Layer 7 DDoS attacks. So let's talk about that and how you can stay protected. Russia's invasion of Ukraine in February of last year basically initiated a new era of cyber war. This cyber war has since extended just beyond those two countries, with more and more parties joining the party. We're now seeing two primary groups of attackers with mostly common motives. The first is the pro-Russian hacktivist group, No Name, Killnet, Anonymous Russia, Passion Group, and so on. They are attacking targets in countries that are supporting Ukraine. So when a country posts public support of Ukraine, they immediately post a list of target organizations within that country and go after them. The second group is a religiously motivated group. Anonymous Sudan, Mysterious Team Bangladesh, Dragon Force Malaysia are just some of the attacker groups in this category. They are going after targets who supposedly insult Muslims. Both of these groups have been very active in the past few months. We're seeing them target organizations worldwide. We're seeing attacks in Australia, Baltics, Canada, Denmark, Germany, Israel, Spain, US, and many more. They're also targeting across industries, whether it's banks and hospitals, universities, government services, critical infrastructure, basically across all industries and all types of organizations. Here you can see just a couple examples of attack campaigns that were observed in the last couple of weeks. Attack on a transportation and critical infrastructure, and an attack on a bank. You can see that the attacks leverage both network and application layer vectors, high capacity, and long duration. That's what's unique about these types of attacks. Bottom line, no one is immune. What we're seeing in recent attack campaigns is that attackers are leveraging new tools to create sophisticated attacks that are harder, sometimes impossible, to detect and mitigate with traditional methods. These new types of HTTPS floods, which we refer to as Web DDoS Tsunami attacks, are more sophisticated, more aggressive, and higher in volume and throughput. They leverage ultra-high RPS requests per second. They're all encrypted, and once you decrypt them, they all look like legitimate requests. And they use multiple and sophisticated evasion techniques, randomized headers, IP spoofing, and so on. They require decryption and deep inspection into the layer 7 headers for accurate detection and mitigation. And that's what makes them harder to detect and mitigate. So why are standard solutions ineffective? Well, network-based DDoS protection solutions cannot detect and mitigate layer 7 DDoS attacks. They're not able to look into the layer 7 headers and accurately detect these attacks. Standard WAFs, whether they're on-prem or cloud, while they are a very effective tool to protect from standard web threats, mainly OWASP top 10 attacks, it's ineffective in dealing with the scale of these attacks and the randomized nature, the fact that there's no predefined signature. And if you, on top of that, any self-managed WAF, on-premise WAF, put a heavy burden on the organization who is unable to cope with the sophistication of these attacks. It requires fully managed and more automated approach. And of course, any rate limiting techniques will impact legitimate traffic. So any solution that leverages rate limit cannot distinguish between malicious traffic and legitimate traffic when under attack, and thus blocking legitimate traffic when under attack. Bottom line, the existing solutions in the market are simply ineffective against these types of web DDoS tsunami attacks. So what is needed to stay protected? To start with, first of all, to be able to protect from these new campaigns, organizations need to have comprehensive, adaptive cloud application and DDoS protection services. Radware provides a best-of-suite one-stop shop that combines DDoS protection, WAF, bot management, and API protection. The solution is fully managed, backed by Radware's emergency response team, so the organization can handle these complex attack vectors, be able to accurately detect and mitigate these multi-vector attacks consistently across all your applications and all your environments. As part of this, we now have a very new and unique offering for web DDoS protection that leverages dedicated behavioral-based algorithms and advanced machine learning capabilities that are specifically designed to detect and quickly mitigate these layer 7 DDoS threats while minimizing the false positives and not impacting legitimate traffic. This offer was specifically built to protect from these new web DDoS tsunami attacks. It offers the best protection in the market and is currently unmatched in the market. No other vendor can give you this level of protection with this accuracy and without blocking legitimate traffic. So to summarize, recent attack campaigns have given rise to a new type of web DDoS attacks. These attacks typically go undetected by traditional protections, including network-based DDoS protection solutions or standard WAF solutions, on-prem or cloud. And even if they go detected, they are blocked leveraging rate-limiting techniques that will block legitimate traffic. Radware is the only one today with our new web DDoS protection solution that can uniquely and accurately detect and mitigate these attacks. Thank you, and stay safe.